So, according to sources, there is a government that hacked into Hillary Clinton's private email server. And we have the person that might know the government that hacked her server. This is Richard Pollack from the Daily Caller Foundation. He is the senior investigative reporter. Thanks for being here.
Thank you.
So, who hacked into Hillary Clinton's private email server?
So the first answer is it's not Russia. We have all this Russia stuff going on today. It is the People's Republic of China through a Chinese state-owned company that is based and operating in Northern Virginia. And they did this for the entire 4 years that Hillary was Secretary of State.
So, did you just like dream this up, or do people actually say this
I actually spoke to a number
out
of former intelligence officials who
loud?
were, in fact, one of them said to me that I asked, well, do you know the name of the company? Said, of course, but he says, I can't tell you the name. Otherwise, I would probably see the inside of a cell
In
if I
other words,
did.
it would be really obvious who gave you the information if they coughed up the name of the company.
Probably. I mean, this
In
is.
this person's
And
estimation.
this person's estimate, well, he said, I just can't tell you. I know the company, but I can't tell you at this time.
And they're in Northern Virginia.
They're operating in Northern Virginia and were operating there in 2009 when Hillary became Secretary of
So,
State.
what gives that guy confidence that they are fronts for the Chinese and that the Chinese government hacked Hillary
Well, and
Clinton's
you have
emails?
multiple sources. It's not just one source, correct?
Right. First of all, I wouldn't have written it if it was one source. The first thing is, Congressman Louie Gohmert actually aired this story last month
Right.
when he cross-examined or interviewed Peter Strzok, who was then the, at one point, was the FBI's chief counterintelligence official, in addition to having an affair with somebody within the bureau and also
Lisa
texting
Page.
Lisa Page. And
Yeah. And he thinks people that shop at Walmart
right,
saw
so
that.
he asked Strzok, as the top counterintelligence official, were you ever approached by the intelligence community's inspector general and told that this company, this country, and a foreign entity of this country had over 4 years in real time broken into Hillary's email server up in upstate New
Right.
York in her mansion. And of course, Strzok said, I sort of met him a couple times. I don't recall what's going on. But when I spoke to a number of people who are very close to the ICIG, they told me that absolutely. It was a Chinese intelligence operation, and it operated. This is the most breathtaking part of the whole thing. It operated in real time. When an email came into her server or she was sending out an email, there would be a courtesy copy printed and then sent to the Chinese.
So, do we know if classified information was sent back and forth between
Absolutely, because the
senders and
ICIG
receivers?
and the State Department's Inspector General have already said that there was classified information throughout her email trove, so to speak.
So, the setup here is that the Chinese government figured out a way to get into her private server in Chappaqua,
Correct.
which is, I guess, in this closet adjoining her bathroom, is the allegation.
In the mansion, yes.
Somewhere in there. And she's got this private server. The Chinese figure out a way to get in there. And then what they're doing is just making a ghost copy of every single email that comes out from that server.
Whether she was emailing the Crown Prince of Saudi Arabia or a head of state in Europe, the Chinese got it in real time within minutes.
Yes.
I mean, this is a big deal. This puts our national security at risk, everything that she was handling from there. And there's a reason why they have these rules in place. They don't want you to have a private email server for this exact reason. And there's a reason why she had a hidden private email server and lied about it and had to destroy all this other stuff. So, I mean, what are the big takeaways from this? And also, have you reached out to the Clintons or anyone else that would have information on this?
Well, we spoke. I actually had an email conversation with Nick Merrill last night, and that is the spokesman for Mrs. Clinton.
Yes.
And it's interesting. He said, well, you know, the FBI considered this to be rubbish. This is not a story. But what he didn't do is he didn't deny our allegation. He did not step and say, this is a false allegation. And in fact, the FBI is Peter Strzok who said that this was an intrusion,
Right.
which, of course, his credibility is zero in this town at this
And in
point.
fact, in July of 2016, looking back, I was looking in preparation for this interview. I
Sure.
went back and I looked at James Comey's statement about what he said. Remember, he makes that famous announcement
Right.
about Hillary Clinton and how she used her server. He
Right.
remember he called it extremely careless
Right.
rather than grossly negligent. That was a Peter Strzok move, by the way, to
Yes.
change the phrasing. And in that statement, he basically assesses that, look, we don't have evidence that a foreign adversary
Right.
invaded this server.
Right.
but we're not ruling it out entirely.
He says it is possible that a hostile actor or a hostile foreign government could have gotten in. What he didn't mention was that it's not just that it got in and out.
Right.
They were there 24/7.
Yes.
On her server. Every single intelligence strategy, every secret that the United States government has, any kind of negotiations that they're doing with a head of state, any kinds of arms deals, all of this information goes immediately to Beijing.
Mm-hmm. Well, I don't think anyone's surprised that the Chinese government would be trying to hack somebody's email and their server. Like,
right.
that is no surprise to me. And but what you were saying before this interview is that potentially this information is being shared with the Russians or any other hostile foreign government, correct?
Correct. I mean, we're talking about the North Koreans, Iran, of which China has very, very close ties, even the Pakistanis, and of course with the Russians too. Now, I don't think they were the only hostile foreign power that was eavesdropping on her emails either. I think this is one case where there was a sophisticated intelligence operation run by the Chinese, run through a Chinese state-owned company in Northern Virginia. But I suspect the Russians were there, the Nigerians, who are notorious for crashing into. Remember, it was a Romanian who actually broke in at one point to her email, Guccifer 2, who broke into her email. And that was the first clue that it was vulnerable to hacking.
Right.
I think this was like what we call in the 1950s and 60s, when you had a telephone line, it wasn't a private line and you were sharing with other people, they called it a party line. I think this was a party line, only it was via email.
Yeah.
So in that hearing from Comey, what we heard, it was July 2016. Was he being honest or was he just being vague enough to cover up maybe the things that they knew?
I think he was just sidestepping a whole bunch of issues. But he does say, he admits, it is possible that a foreign actor, hostile foreign government, may have intruded and we were not able to pick it up. He
right.
says that in his July 5th statement, which was the statement which he basically says, we're not going to indict Hillary.
So who concludes ultimately that this is the Chinese government that is in the inside of Hillary's server? Is it the ICIG? Did they conclude, hey, it's the Chinese that are doing this?
Yes.
And that would suggest, by the way, based on Comey's statement, that the timeline for the ICIG concluding that, either Comey's lying or they concluded it after Comey made his statement in July 2016.
Well, according to my sources, the intelligence, the ICIG, saw the anomaly in her server in early 2015,
mm-hmm.
and they reported it pretty quickly to the FBI and to Strzok. I'm told that when they reported it to Strzok, Strzok seemed disinterested. He was cold and harsh. He was not welcoming. Remember, he was the top counterintelligence official for the FBI at this time. He's the gatekeeper about what kind of information the FBI should do in terms of either launching a field investigation, indicting people, surveilling people. And he basically had pushed back and said, get away from me. He
right.
was very cold and very uninterested in what the ICIG had to say. So, they presented in multiple meetings, by the way, their findings. It wasn't just one meeting. And in each case, there was pushback from him. He didn't want to hear it. He didn't want to hear the bad news, according to my sources.
Mm-hmm. And so where do we go from here now that we have sources that are coming out saying this? I mean, will there be some sort of follow-up? I know that a lot of people are still upset because they feel like the Clintons, there's, you know, two sets of rules, one for every other everyday Americans and then the Clintons.
Well, you know, the Clinton story is all about the rules don't apply to them. I mean, that's been their whole MO. And but I think that we have to figure out whether or not the U.S. government is still doing a damage assessment concerning this, whether or not there could be a continuing investigation in the Justice Department or whether it's been dropped. Who dropped it? Was it Sally Yates or Loretta Lynch that dropped it? Was it dropped by someone in the Trump Justice Department? We don't know. So there's a lot more that we have to figure out. What happened after these important pieces of intelligence is given to the FBI and the Justice Department, and I believe it was given to the entire intelligence community as well. What steps did Clapper or Brennan, all the other national security officials, Susan Rice, who was the national security advisor to President Obama, what did these people do? What steps did they take? So I think that there needs to be historic walk back as to
right.
what really happened. What did they do? What did they not do? And I think that that story is still very much alive.
Well, and I feel like President Trump is tweeting about this a lot. Like, he feels that there's some sort of fishing expedition going on with him. There's a witch hunt. Yet there's a lot of, you know, information and, you know, damaging things like this report for other people involved. And so he's wondering why there hasn't been any sort of follow-up.
You know, in Aspen, I guess it was last month, Chris Wray, who's the current FBI director, said that actually the most dangerous country, in his opinion, in terms of a hostile force is not Russia, but it's China.
Right. Yeah.
And China is direct.
Most experts agree with you on that.
Right. And you know, they are challenging the United States in the South China Sea, other parts of the Pacific. They have a new, robust, very modernized Navy. They've been doing some flybys with some of our jets and bombers. So I think that while the mainstream media is talking about Russia this, Russia that,
right.
Meanwhile, here is China over here, and no one talks about it in real ways.
Yeah, it's kind of amazing to think. And meanwhile, the Clinton people are like, there's no way even like that Russian foreign governments of any kind probe this private email server, which is, of course, absurd on its face. But now we find out, it went much deeper than that. China got in, and now they're taking all those emails.
I mean, absolutely.
Anthony Weiner had access to Hillary Clinton's emails. So could you imagine? The whole world probably has seen anything she's been receiving.
Yeah, and we've seen a lot of Anthony Weiner.
Yes.
Can you imagine?
Too much.
And the Chinese had a preview of it, too. Yeah.
Any final thoughts, Richard?
I don't want to end this discussion with Anthony Weiner.
Are you done your reporting entirely? Are you done on this story? You're giving up?
No. I think the story has legs. There's lots of questions, and you're going to see a lot more stuff coming from me and from my fellows over at the Daily Caller News Foundation.
That's a tease. That means more is coming.
More is coming.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thanks, Richard.